everybody, it's Sharon. Have you ever seen this view of San Francisco? Well, if not that view, have you seen this view? Well, a few weeks ago, I was thrilled to have a tour of one of the Painted Ladies, 712 Steiner. And my tour guide was none other than the owner of the house, George Horsfall. Let's see what he had to show us.
The Queen Anne-style cottages known as the Painted Ladies were built by Matthew Cavanaugh in the last decade of the 19th century. He himself lived in the largest one, number 722, at the corner of Steiner and Grove. The first owner-occupant of 712 Steiner was Claire Platt and her husband Frank, a prominent dentist. I don't have a picture of Claire. But the deed was in her name. It survived the earthquake and fire of 1906, but was sold to an investor who sometimes lived in it, sometimes rented it out, and eventually went through a succession of owners. In 2001, Catherine Horsfall bought it. From that point on, she, with the help of her son George, restored it, enhanced it, and lived in it until her death in January 2021. George is now offering tours of the Blue Painted Lady. You can find out more about them on Instagram at Blue Painted Lady House Tours. Cavanaugh's house plans were basically the same layout, 3 or 4 stories and 2,500 plus square feet. As you enter George's house, you're in the formal parlor. The bay window looks out over Alamo Square, and this time you're on the inside looking out. You're struck by how quiet and private it is. The stained glass crystal casts a rainbow at the right time of day next to the portrait of George's grandmother's grandmother. The fireplace mantel and tile is original, and the decorative plasterwork separating one parlor from the next is a favorite of the Victorians. Uniquely Cavanaugh touch, each of the 7 homes contains a Venus ornament. Adding to the spirit of the Victorians is the Bradbury and Bradbury wallpaper, this on the ceiling, with an original medallion and a beautiful Victorian light fixture. George's kitchen is quite modern, but the Victorians wouldn't have objected. They were all about modern conveniences, like indoor plumbing and electricity. And out the back window, you can see their small formal garden. As we go up to the second story, we see more features of a Matthew Cavanaugh home. The unique woodwork on the stair rail, the art glass on the first landing. And as we go up to the master bedroom, we pass numerous photos of George's family, who have been in San Francisco since the 1850s. Again, the Bradbury and Bradbury wallpaper decorates the room. And on the third floor, a surprise, a small museum containing objects from his family that date back to the 1880s. Wedding cake saved from 1885 has to take the cake. And remember that view I showed you at the beginning? Well, that's the view from the third floor.
Thanks for joining me today. Catch you later. Bye.